हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू प्रशांत आईएएस। सो फ्रेंड्स, इन द लास्ट क्लास वी हैव कंप्लीटेड अवर डिस्कशन टिल द अपर हाउस ऑफ द पार्लियामेंट मींस राज्यसभा, एंड इन दिस क्लास वी विल स्टार्ट अ डिस्कशन विद द लोअर हाउस ऑफ पार्लियामेंट मींस लोकसभा। ओके, सो लेट्स बिगिन। सो फ्रेंड्स, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल स्टार्ट अ डिस्कशन विथ द मेंबर्स ऑफ लोकसभा। Means how many members are there in Lok Sabha? What is the maximum strength of Lok Sabha? So what is our first question? So our first question is that what is the maximum strength of Lok Sabha? How many maximum members are there in Lok Sabha? So friends, first of all, we will discuss according to the Constitution of India. Means what are the provisions in the Constitution of India regarding the members of Lok Sabha? Okay, now friends, if we talk of Indian states, okay, states means, for example, the state of Madhya Pradesh, Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, Telangana, Kerala, Tamil Nadu, okay. So, if we talk of all the states of India, then the maximum number of members, okay, listen to my words carefully, according to the Constitution of India, the maximum number of members in Lok Sabha from all the states together can be 530, okay. Listen again. According to the Constitution of India, the maximum number of members from all the states together in Lok Sabha can be 530. Okay, so 530 is the maximum number of members in Lok Sabha from all the states of India. Okay, now friends, if we talk of Union Territories, now Union Territories, for example, the Union Territory of Delhi, Union Territory of Pondicherry, okay, so if we talk of Union Territories, so the maximum number of members from all the Union Territories of India together can be 20. Okay, so according to the Constitution of India, the maximum number of members from all the Union Territories together can be 20. Now friends, earlier there was a provision for the nomination of two members. Okay, so earlier there was a provision in the Constitution for two nominated members also, but now it has been removed from the Constitution of India. So currently there are no nominated members in Lok Sabha. Okay, so currently there are no nominated members in Lok Sabha. So okay, so what is the maximum strength of Lok Sabha according to the Constitution of India? What are the maximum number of members which can be in Lok Sabha according to the Constitution of India? So you have to sum up both of these numbers, and when you will sum up both these numbers, then the result will come as 550. So friends, you can say that 550 is the maximum number of members. 550 is the maximum number of members in Lok Sabha according to the Constitution of India. Or you can also say that according to the Constitution of India, the maximum strength of Lok Sabha, the maximum number of members in Lok Sabha is 550. So friends, till now we have discussed about the membership of Lok Sabha according to the Constitution of India. But now we will discuss about the membership of Lok Sabha according to the parliamentary law. Now friends, the law of parliament or parliamentary law is definitely made in accordance with the provisions of Constitution. Means the law of parliament is made according by keeping the provisions of Constitution in mind. Okay, but the actual working on ground takes place according to the parliamentary law. Okay, so actual working on ground takes place according to the parliamentary law. So now we will discuss that what is the status of members of Lok Sabha according to the law of parliament. So friends, first of all, we will discuss about earlier system, and then I will talk about the current system. Okay, so first of all, we will discuss about that what was the earlier system. So friends, earlier what was the scene, that there the maximum number of members from all the states of India in Lok Sabha was 530. Okay, so earlier what was the scene, that the maximum number of members from all the states of India, maximum number of members from all the states of India in Lok Sabha was 530. After that, okay, after that, if we talk of Union Territories, then the maximum number of members from all the Union Territories of India in Lok Sabha was 13, ओके, सो 530 मेंबर्स फ्रॉम ऑल द स्टेट एंड 13 मेंबर्स फ्रॉम ऑल द यूनियन टेरिटरीज. मोर ओवर देयर वाज आल्सो अ प्रोविजन ऑफ टू नॉमिनेटेड मेंबर्स. बट व्हाट हैपेंड फ्रेंड्स, व्हाट हैपेंड दैट लेटर ऑन बाय अ कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल अमेंडमेंट द प्रोविजन फॉर दीज टू नॉमिनेटेड मेंबर्स वॉज रिमूव्ड फ्रॉम द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन ऑफ इंडिया. ओके, सो द प्रोविजन फॉर द नॉमिनेटेड मेंबर्स इन लोकसभा वॉज रिमूव्ड फ्रॉम द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन ऑफ इंडिया. सो नाउ करेंटली देर आर नो मोर नॉमिनेटेड मेंबर्स इन द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन इन द लोकसभा. देर आर नो मोर नॉमिनेटेड मेंबर्स इन लोकसभा. सो वॉट वॉज द अर्लियर सिस्टम दैट देर वर 530 मेंबर्स फ्रॉम स्टेट्स एंड 13 मेंबर्स फ्रॉम यूनियन टेरिटरीज. नाउ फ्रेंड्स वॉट हैपन्ड, ओके, व्हाट हैपेंड, नाउ दिस वाज द सिस्टम व्हेन जम्मू एंड कश्मीर वाज अ स्टेट. ओके, सो दिस वाज द सिस्टम व्हेन जम्मू एंड कश्मीर वाज अ स्टेट. नाउ फ्रेंड्स लेटर ऑन व्हाट हैपेंड दैट जम्मू एंड कश्मीर वाज बाइफरकेटेड इनटू टू यूनियन टेरिटरीज. नाउ द नंबर ऑफ मेंबर्स फ्रॉम जम्मू एंड कश्मीर, ओके, सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट द टाइम पीरियड व्हेन जम्मू एंड कश्मीर वाज अ स्टेट. सो व्हेन जम्मू एंड कश्मीर वाज अ स्टेट एट दैट पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम देयर वर टोटल 6 लोकसभा सीट्स और 6 लोकसभा मेंबर्स फ्रॉम जम्मू एंड कश्मीर. ओके, सो व्हेन जम्मू एंड कश्मीर वाज अ स्टेट, सो देयर वर टोटल 6 लोकसभा मेंबर्स फ्रॉम द स्टेट ऑफ जम्मू एंड कश्मीर. ओके, सो डेफिनेटली इफ वी टॉक ऑफ स्टेट्स देन वी कैन से दैट 524 मेंबर्स फ्रॉम अदर स्टेट्स प्लस 6 मेंबर्स फ्रॉम द स्टेट ऑफ जम्मू एंड कश्मीर. सो द टोटल मेंबरशिप वॉज 530. ओके, सो व्हाट वी कैन से, वी कैन से दैट देयर वर 524 मेंबर्स फ्रॉम अदर स्टेट्स एंड 6 मेंबर्स फ्रॉम द स्टेट ऑफ जम्मू कश्मीर. सो देयर वर टोटल 530 मेंबर्स. नाउ फ्रेंड्स व्हाट हैपेंड लेटर ऑन दैट जम्मू एंड कश्मीर वॉज एक्चुअली बाइफरकेटेड इंटू टू यूनियन टेरिटरीज. यूनियन, ओके, सो एंड व्हाट वर दीज यूनियन टेरिटरीज, द यूनियन टेरिटरी ऑफ जम्मू एंड कश्मीर एंड द यूनियन टेरिटरी ऑफ लद्दाख. ओके, सो यूनियन टेरिटरी ऑफ जम्मू एंड कश्मीर एंड द यूनियन टेरिटरी ऑफ लद्दाख. नाउ द यूनियन टेरिटरी ऑफ लद्दाख वॉज हैविंग 1 लोकसभा सीट. ओके, एंड टोटल हाउ मेनी लोकसभा सीट्स वर देयर, टोटल 6 लोकसभा सीट्स वर देयर. सो द यूनियन टेरिटरी ऑफ जम्मू एंड कश्मीर वॉज लेफ्ट विद टोटल 5 लोकसभा सीट्स. ओके, सो नाउ 1 लोकसभा सीट बिलोंग्स टू द यूनियन टेरिटरी ऑफ लद्दाख एंड 5 लोकसभा सीट्स बिलोंग टू द यूनियन टेरिटरी ऑफ जम्मू एंड कश्मीर. ओके, सो नाउ व्हाट हैपेंड फ्रेंड्स दैट दीस अर्लियर व्हेन जम्मू एंड कश्मीर वाज अ स्टेट, सो व्हाट हैपेंड दैट दीस 6 सीट्स वर इंक्लूडेड इन द स्टेट्स. बट व्हेन द बट नाउ एज जम्मू एंड कश्मीर इज नो मोर अ स्टेट, सो हाउ मेनी सीट्स आर फ्रॉम स्टेट, 524. ओके, एंड द सीट्स ऑफ जम्मू एंड कश्मीर एंड लद्दाख, ओके, एज जम्मू एंड कश्मीर इज ऑल्सो यूनियन टेरिटरी एंड लद्दाख इज ऑल्सो यूनियन टेरिटरी. सो अर्लियर देर वर 13 सीट्स फ्रॉम यूनियन टेरिटरीज, बट नाउ 5 सीट्स फ्रॉम जम्मू एंड कश्मीर एंड 1 सीट फ्रॉम लद्दाख विल ऑल्सो बी एडेड. सो करेंटली वट इज द सिस्टम दैट करेंटली देर आर 524 सीट्स फ्रॉम स्टेट्स एंड 19 सीट्स फ्रॉम यूनियन टेरिटरीज. ओके, सो इफ वी टॉक ऑफ करेंट सिस्टम अकॉर्डिंग टू द लॉ ऑफ पार्लियामेंट और इफ वी टॉक ऑफ करेंट सिस्टम विच इज एक्चुअली फॉलोड इन इंडिया, सो द करेंट सिस्टम इज दैट मैक्सिमम नंबर ऑफ मेंबर्स फ्रॉम ऑल द स्टेट्स ऑफ इंडिया, मैक्सिमम नंबर ऑफ मेंबर्स फ्रॉम ऑल द स्टेट्स ऑफ इंडिया इन लोकसभा इज 524. ओके, सो 524 आर द मेंबर्स फ्रॉम स्टेट्स. एंड इफ वी टॉक ऑफ यूनियन टेरिटरीज देन द मैक्सिमम नंबर ऑफ मेंबर्स फ्रॉम ऑल द यूनियन टेरिटरीज ऑफ इंडिया इन लोकसभा इज 19. सो 19 मेंबर्स आर फ्रॉम यूनियन टेरिटरीज. सो दिस इज द करेंट सिस्टम. नाउ व्हाट इज द टोटल मेंबरशिप ऑफ लोकसभा, व्हाट इज द टोटल स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ लोकसभा, सो यू हैव टू ऐड 524 विद 19. So when you will add both of these numbers, then the result will come as 543. So you can say that the total strength of Lok Sabha or the maximum number of members in Lok Sabha is 543. Now friends, one thing I want to tell you is that Lok Sabha is also known as the popular chamber or the popular house of parliament. Now why it is called popular chamber or why it is called popular house or what is the meaning of this? So now I will tell you. So friends, as I have told you about Rajya Sabha, so what happened in Rajya Sabha that the members of Rajya Sabha were indirectly elected. Okay, so the members of Rajya Sabha were indirectly elected, means they were not elected by people directly, they were elected by the elected members of स्टेट लेजिस्लेटिव असेंबलीज. ओके, और हु आर द इलेक्टेड मेंबर्स ऑफ स्टेट लेजिस्लेटिव असेंबलीज? सो यू कैन से दैट द मेंबर्स ऑफ राज्यसभा आर इलेक्टेड बाय द इलेक्टेड MLAs of legislative assemblies. Okay, so who elect the members of Rajya Sabha? So the members of Rajya Sabha are elected by the elected MLAs of state legislative assemblies. Okay, and these MLAs are elected by whom? These MLAs are elected by people. So what we can say that the members of Rajya Sabha are not directly elected by people. They are elected by the they are elected indirectly by the elected MLAs of state legislative assemblies. But friends, if we talk of the 543 members of Lok Sabha, okay, so if we talk of all the members of Lok Sabha, then what happens that these members of Lok Sabha are directly elected by the people. Okay, so these members of Lok Sabha are directly elected by the people, means people give them vote. People chooses the members of Lok Sabha. People give vote in the elections of Lok Sabha. Okay, so the members of Lok Sabha, all the members of Lok Sabha are directly elected by people. Directly elected by people means people give vote. People give vote in the elections of Lok Sabha. Directly elected by Lok Sabha, directly elected by people means people directly chooses the members of Lok Sabha. And as directly people chooses the members of Lok Sabha, that's why Lok Sabha is also known as popular chamber or the popular house of parliament. Popular means which is more popular among masses. Okay, popular means it is the house of people. And why it is the house of people? Because people directly elects the members of Lok Sabha. And as people directly elects the members of Lok Sabha, so what happens that the members of Lok Sabha are the direct representative of the people of India. And as the members of Lok Sabha are the direct representatives of the people of India, that's why Lok Sabha is also called popular chamber or popular house of the parliament. Now friends, let us discuss about the special powers of Lok Sabha. So the first special power of Lok Sabha is regarding money bill. So Rajya Sabha has very special and overriding powers in the matter of money bill. Now what is the I am talking about Lok Sabha. Okay, so if I have mistakenly said Rajya Sabha, then please forgive me. I just wanted to say Lok Sabha. Okay, so I am repeating the statement. So friends, Lok Sabha enjoys overriding and special powers in the passage of money bill. Okay, Lok Sabha enjoys overriding and special powers in the matter of money bill. Now I will explain you. So the first thing is that I have told you that if this is the Parliament of India, then there are two houses of Parliament, Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha. So Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha are the two houses of the Parliament. Now friends, if we talk of money bill, then money bill can only be introduced in Lok Sabha. Okay, money bill can only be introduced in Lok Sabha. Money bill cannot be introduced in Rajya Sabha. So first thing you have to remember that the first special power of Lok Sabha regarding money bill is that money bill can only be introduced in Lok Sabha. Money bill cannot be introduced in Rajya Sabha. Now friends, let's suppose that a money bill is introduced in Lok Sabha and the Lok Sabha passed that bill. Now first of all, which majority is needed to pass a money bill in Lok Sabha? Okay, or which majority is needed to pass a money bill? So friends, the simple majority is needed to pass a money bill. Now what is the meaning of simple majority? So simple majority means more than 50% of the members present and voting. Okay, more than 50% of the members present and voting. So a money bill can be passed by simple majority only. Now friends, let's suppose a money bill was introduced in Lok Sabha and that money bill is passed in Lok Sabha. Okay, and once the money bill is passed in Lok Sabha, then that money bill will be sent to Rajya Sabha. Okay, now let's suppose that the money bill is passed by Lok Sabha and it is sent to Rajya Sabha. Now friends, once the money bill in Rajya Sabha, then Rajya Sabha has two options. Okay, so what Rajya Sabha has? Rajya Sabha has two options regarding money bill. The first option is to pass the bill. Okay, means pass the bill in the original form as it was passed by Lok Sabha. So the first option which Rajya Sabha has, that Rajya Sabha can pass the bill without doing anything. Okay, Raj Sabha can simply pass the bill. Now, what is the second option? Second option is that Raj Sabha can send this bill. Okay, Raj Sabha can send this bill back to Lok Sabha. Okay. Raj Sabha can send this bill back to Lok Sabha with some recommendations. Means Raj Sabha can recommend that please bring these changes in the bill. These are not the good provisions of the bill. So please bring these changes in the bill. So what the second option Raj Sabha has? So the second option which Raj Sabha has is Raj Sabha can point out some recommendations. Raj Sabha can give the recommendations and then Raj Sabha can send this bill to Lok Sabha back. Okay. Now friends, if we talk of first option, then definitely in this case, the bill is passed by both the houses of parliament, okay? But if we talk of second option, then what is happening in second option? That what Raj Sabha is actually doing, Raj Sabha is just pointing out, is just giving some recommendations. And after giving these recommendations, Raj Sabha is sending the bill back to Lok Sabha. Now let's suppose that Raj Sabha has sent that bill back to Lok Sabha and now Lok Sabha is having that bill. Now friends, again Lok Sabha has two options this time. Okay, so this time Lok Sabha is also having two options. The first option is to accept the recommendations given by Raj Sabha. Okay, the first option is to accept the recommendations passed by Raj Sabha. And the second option is to reject all the recommendations given by Raj Sabha. The second option is to reject all the recommendations given by Raj Sabha. Now friends, in both of these conditions, what will happen? That the bill is considered to be passed by both the houses of parliament. Now what do I mean to say when I say this? So I want to say that if Lok Sabha accepts the amendments or recommendations given by Raj Sabha, okay, so in first condition what will happen, that in first condition Lok Sabha is actually accepting the recommendation or the amendments given by Raj Sabha. So in this case, definitely if Lok Sabha is accepting the recommendations given by Raj Sabha, so the bill will be passed by both the houses of parliament. But friends, in second condition what is happening, that Lok Sabha is not accepting the recommendations or amendments proposed by the Raj Sabha to that bill. Okay, Lok Sabha is not accepting the recommendations given by Raj Sabha. So friends, even if Lok Sabha does not accept the recommendations given by Raj Sabha, then also the bill will be passed. Then also the bill is considered to be passed. Okay, so no matter whether Lok Sabha will accept the recommendations given by Raj Sabha or Lok Sabha will reject the recommendations given by Raj Sabha, in both of the conditions, the money bill is passed. So what can you say? So you can say that the recommendations given by Raj Sabha are actually not powerful. The recommendations given by Raj Sabha are not powerful. Means Raj Sabha cannot force. First of all, Raj Sabha cannot amend anything in money bill. Okay. So Raj Sabha does not have the power to amend the money bill. Raj Sabha does not have the power to amend even a single thing from a money bill. And the second thing is that even if Raj Sabha is sending some recommendations to Lok Sabha, then also the recommendations of Raj Sabha are not that powerful. Means Lok Sabha can either accept the recommendations or Lok Sabha can also reject the recommendations. And if Lok Sabha rejects the recommendations or accepts the recommendation, in both of these cases the bill will be passed. Okay, in both of these cases the bill is considered to be passed. Okay, now friends, there is one more thing. Okay, now I have told you that Raj Sabha is having two options once a bill is sent to Raj Sabha. Okay, so the first option is that Raj Sabha can pass that bill, or second option is that Raj Sabha can send this bill back to Lok Sabha with some recommendations, with some amendments. Okay, means with some recommendations to do amendment. Now friends, Raj Sabha only has 14 days period to do both of these things. Okay, so Raj Sabha has to either pass that bill or Raj Sabha has to send this bill back to Lok Sabha with some recommendations. So Raj Sabha has to do this within 14 days. Raj Sabha has limited time. Raj Sabha only has 14 days. Now friends, you will ask that sir, what will happen if Rajya Sabha will not pass that bill or will not send this bill back to Lok Sabha within 14 days. Okay, so friends, what will happen that a money bill must be returned to Lok Sabha within 14 days. Okay, or what will happen that the bill is deemed to have passed by both the houses in the form it was originally passed by Lok Sabha. Okay, so are you getting my point? So what will happen that if Rajya Sabha will not give its reaction on the bill for next 14 days, means if Rajya Sabha will not pass that bill or Rajya Sabha will not send that bill back to Lok Sabha within 14 days, then what will happen? Then it will be considered that the bill is passed by the both the houses of parliament. Then it will be considered that the bill is passed by Lok Sabha as well as the bill is passed by Rajya Sabha. Okay? So if Rajya Sabha does not give its reaction on the money bill for the 14 days, if Rajya Sabha does not react on money bill for the 14 days, then what happens? Then it is considered that the bill is already passed by Rajya Sabha. So you can see that the powers of Rajya Sabha are very limited, very less in the matters of money bill. Rajya Sabha has negligible or no power in the matter of money bill. All the powers lies with Lok Sabha in the matter of money bill. Money bill can be introduced in Lok Sabha. Okay. Lok Sabha passes the money bill with simple majority. Okay, when the money bill is sent to Rajya Sabha and if Rajya Sabha does not react on that bill for next 14 days, then it is considered that the money bill is passed by Rajya Sabha. Okay, even if Rajya Sabha gives some recommendations regarding the amendments in the bill, and if Lok Sabha rejects all these recommendations, then also the bill is considered to be passed by both the houses of parliament. So what we can conclude? We can conclude that all the powers are with Lok Sabha in the matter of money bill. Okay, so if we are talking of money bill, then the powers of Rajya Sabha are negligible. Rajya Sabha is having no power in the matter of money bill. All the powers in the matter of money bill lies with Lok Sabha. So Lok Sabha is very, very powerful in the matter of money bill. Now friends, after this, no confidence motion can only be introduced in Lok Sabha. Okay, so no confidence motion cannot be introduced in Rajya Sabha. No confidence motion can only be introduced in Lok Sabha. Now what is the meaning of no confidence motion? So no confidence motion is actually brought against the government or council of ministers. Okay, so no confidence motion is brought against government or the council of ministers. And if the no confidence motion is passed, then what happens? That the council of ministers is removed or the government is removed. Okay, so what is no confidence motion? So no confidence motion is brought in Lok Sabha against the government or council of ministers, and if the no confidence motion is passed by Lok Sabha, then what happens? That the government is removed, then the council of ministers is removed. Okay, so the first special power of Lok Sabha regarding no confidence motion is that no confidence motion can only be introduced in Lok Sabha. Now the second thing is that no confidence motion can only be passed by Lok Sabha. Okay, so the no confidence motion is neither introduced in Rajya Sabha nor it is passed by Rajya Sabha. Okay, so Rajya Sabha has to do nothing with the no confidence motion. No confidence motion is introduced in Lok Sabha as well as it is passed by Lok Sabha. And if the no confidence motion is passed by Rajya Sabha, then what happens? That the government is removed. Now friends, after this, Finance Bill Category A, okay, Finance Bill Category A can only be introduced in Lok Sabha. Okay, now what are Finance Bill Category A? So when I will teach you about the types of bills, for example, Ordinary Bill, Constitutional Amendment Bill, Money Bill, Finance Bill Category A, Finance Bill Category B, okay, so in that class I will teach you about Finance Bill Category A in detail. Okay, so for the time being you just understand that Finance Bill Category A is just a type of bill, and this type of bill can only be introduced in Lok Sabha. So this is again a special power of Lok Sabha, that Finance Bill Category A can only be introduced in Lok Sabha. This type of bill cannot be introduced in Rajya Sabha. Now friends, if we talk of the joint sitting of both the houses of parliament. Now what is the joint sitting of both the houses of parliament? So joint sitting means when all the members of Lok Sabha and all the members of Rajya Sabha they sit together and then they discuss on a issue. Okay, so now later on I will tell you about joint sitting in much a detailed manner. Okay, so when I will take the dedicated lecture of joint sitting, in that lecture I will teach you about joint sitting in a much detailed manner. For the time being, you just understand that joint sitting means that when the members of both the houses of parliament, when the members of Lok Sabha as well as the members of Rajya Sabha sit together for discussing a issue, for voting on a issue. Okay, it can be a bill or anything else also. So what happens that any joint sitting of both the houses of parliament, so what happens in the joint sitting of both the houses of parliament, that this sitting, okay, means the joint sitting of Lok Sabha plus Rajya Sabha. So who is the presiding officer? Who is the presiding officer of this type of meeting of parliament? So friends, the speaker of Lok Sabha, okay, the speaker of Lok Sabha is the presiding officer of the joint sitting of parliament. Means the presiding officer of the joint sitting of parliament is the speaker of Lok Sabha. Okay, and definitely as the speaker is the officer of Lok Sabha, so we can also say that this is again a special power of Lok Sabha, that if Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha sits together, if there is a joint sitting of Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha, then speaker, okay, then the speaker of Lok Sabha is made the presiding officer. So you have to remember that if there is a joint sitting of both the houses of parliament, then the chairman of Rajya Sabha does not become the presiding officer. Who becomes the presiding officer? So the speaker of Lok Sabha becomes the presiding officer of the joint sitting of parliament. So again, this is a special power of Lok Sabha. Now friends, after this, let us discuss about the responsibility of Council of Ministers. Okay, so I have told you that the Council of Ministers means government. So the Council of Ministers is responsible to the lower house of the parliament, and definitely Lok Sabha is the lower house of the parliament. So what happens in India, that the Council of Ministers is responsible to Lok Sabha. Now what is the meaning when I say that the Council of Ministers is responsible to Lok Sabha? So it means that Lok Sabha, okay, it means that Lok Sabha can ask questions, okay, Lok Sabha can ask questions to the members of Council of Ministers, to the Council of Ministers regarding their work, and Council of Ministers has to give the answers asked by Lok Sabha. Okay, now friends, Lok Sabha also has the power to punish. Lok Sabha also has the power to punish Council of Ministers. Okay, so what does it mean? It means that Lok Sabha, it means that let's suppose that if any work of Council of Ministers is not good, okay, so according to Lok Sabha, if some work of Council of Ministers is not in the interest of public, or if Lok Sabha thinks that Council of Ministers is not doing their work properly, so Lok Sabha can also punish Council of Ministers. Now punishing Council of Ministers means Lok Sabha can even remove Council of Ministers from their post. Okay, how? So definitely there are many ways which Lok Sabha has to remove Council of Ministers. For example, one of the way I have discussed in the beginning of the class, that Lok Sabha can pass no confidence motion. Okay, so Lok Sabha can pass no confidence motion, and by passing no confidence motion, Lok Sabha can remove the Council of Ministers. So this is again a special power of Lok Sabha, that the Council of Ministers is responsible towards Lok Sabha. Council of Ministers is not responsible towards Rajya Sabha. So you have to remember that Council of Ministers is not responsible towards Rajya Sabha. Means Rajya Sabha do not have the power. Rajya Sabha does not have the power to punish Council of Ministers. Rajya Sabha cannot remove Council of Ministers. Okay, but Lok Sabha has the power to punish Council of Ministers. Lok Sabha can even remove Council of Ministers. So we can say that again, Lok Sabha is very, very powerful. This is again a special power of Lok Sabha. Now friends, let's suppose that there is an ongoing national emergency in the country. Okay, so let's suppose there is a national emergency in the country. Now let's suppose that there is a need. Okay, now let's suppose there is an urgent need to withdraw or to end this national emergency. Okay, so there is a need to end this national emergency. Now friends, the resolution asking for the disapproval of the ongoing national emergency can only be introduced and passed in Lok Sabha. Okay, so what I want to say is that if there is any national emergency in the country, if there is any ongoing national emergency in the country, and then there is a need to end this national emergency, then the resolution asking for the disapproval of this national emergency. Means the resolution asking for the ending, for the end of this national emergency, can first of all introduced in Lok Sabha only. Okay, so this type of resolution can only be introduced in Lok Sabha. Moreover, this type of resolution can only be passed by Lok Sabha. Okay, so if there is any ongoing national emergency in the country, and if there is a need to end that national emergency, then the proposal, then the resolution for the ending of that national emergency, for the withdrawal or for the disapproval of that national emergency, can only be initiated, can only be introduced and passed by Lok Sabha. So friends, that's all for today. I hope that you all must have enjoyed the lecture, and if you have enjoyed the lecture, then please like the video, comment, share this video, share this channel to all the people you know who are preparing for UPSC or any other state PSC. Subscribe the channel, press the bell icon and select all. Now friends, we will meet in next class. Till then, take care of yourself. Thank you.